I'm Frenchy.
And I'm Freedom.
And this is Let's Play Civilization 6. I've played every Civilization game up until now, and I'm still not that good. So, play single player. Let's just create a game, see where it takes us. I've played the tutorial, and that's it. I'm gonna do a random leader on Prince or Warlord.
Let's do Warlord.
F it, let's do Prince. Standard, we're gonna do random. Can we do, is there a random? Shuffle. And standard. Let's see what the advanced, okay, so you can set victory conditions, limit turns by game speed. Ooh, no barbarians? Duplicate leaders? You can have duplicate leaders. Option prevents two or more players from choosing the same leader. Oh, no duplicate leaders. Okay. That sounds good. Alright, start the game. So, this is going to be a little bit longer of a series, I'd imagine. Because these games take a long time.
I always do it on like the quickest settings. Like
standard's
like
fine.
Could do a marathon.
Yeah, right. Marathon is cool. Once someone asked me why you would ever do marathon, and marathon's cool if you want to micro. Your decisions have a lot more impact in a marathon setting.
Like, from the first stirrings of life beneath water
to the great Brazilian beasts empire.
Of the Stone Age. To man taking the first steps, you have come far. Now begins your greatest quest. From this early cradle of civilization on towards the stars. Your people look to you, Emperor Pedro II, to lead Brazil onto the world stage. Use your reputation as a patron of artists, scientists, and engineers to draw the greatest minds to our fertile home. For it is in the lush rainforests, teeming with life, that your people thrive. Watch them in the carnival as they dance the samba in celebration of your great feats, Pedro the Magnanimous.
All right. So Jeremy isn't wearing headphones. That's the reason he couldn't hear it. But
I bet I would have done a better voice acting job.
I don't know. So we're playing as Pedro the Second. Who's great, apparently, at generating great people. I actually don't know what any of the leaders do, except for I played as Gilgamesh in the tutorial.
What does he want to do, not die? What's his, like, special thing? Like, looking for youth?
I forget. But, okay, so this guy, he's good in rainforests. He has adjacency bonuses for his districts. A unique naval unit, so I want to at least try to get at least one city on the sea. And a street carnival, which it looks like maybe it replaces the market? I'm not quite sure. I'll have to look it up as soon as I get in, just so I know. By market, of course, I mean the commercial district. But I could be wrong. So this game added a new system where your hexes can be turned, are utilized.
City hexes.
Yeah, your city hexes are used for these districts. And so there are some buildings, some structures are district specific, so you need to build the district before you build the that upgrade. Plus these have like different effects, so it seems like you're a little bit more customizable. I don't know if I'll be like hurting for space at one point, maybe. I didn't get too far past the ancient civilization, the ancient era within the
tutorial.
The tutorial, yeah. So we're just kind of waiting. This is always like the worst part. These games do take a long time to load because they have to generate the entire terrain. They have to generate starting positions, stuff like that. So it does take a little while to get in. Right now, I think we've been waiting 2 or 3 minutes on this loading screen, but it's like the only loading you have to do.
Oh, you guys can skip it. Maybe we should have said that at the beginning.
Yeah, you guys can absolutely skip it.
But maybe I can put like a little thing.
Maybe.
I've never done that.
It's about to start though.
Like, skip to this point if you just want to start.
As your personal advisor, I am qualified to assist you in all matters related.
My only two options were new to Civ and new to Civ 6.
I don't need your help.
All right, so this is 100% rainforest, which is like what I'm ideal at here. So this is going to be good for my starting location. I'm also starting next to a river, which is very important for your starting population. You need a source of fresh water, which rivers are. Otherwise, you're...
I just settled on right there.
Yeah, I will. Oh, I accidentally tried to end the turn or something. So, Rio. So I could get an achievement. There's an achievement for building like some sort of arena, and then some the Cristo Redento in Rio de Janeiro.
Oh yeah.
It's like a Olympics themed. So let's explore here. First thing I'm going to build is a scoot, I think. Yeah, I'm going to a scoochy booty man.
Was like we said, we played every Civilization game, even from the time we were like 6 or 7 years old. We were playing Civilization 1. We have time in every single game, even if like Civ 2 or 3, we didn't play that much of, but we still played some of it, you know. Played Civ Revolutions on the PS4.
Yeah.
I think there's like a space one that we haven't played.
Alpha Centauri.
Yeah, but then there's also like Civilization Beyond Earth or something like that.
Oh yeah.
And we haven't played that, and that's like the only one we haven't played.
I went to like the absolute wrong place for this,
Cause you got a
all this terrain, and yeah. It's really slowing them down.
But doesn't that make you see farther?
Yeah, standing on hills does make you see farther, but there's this mountain in the way, so it doesn't. I'm not really seeing that much. Looks like I'm maybe towards the southern end of the continent. There's some snow on the ground. I'll send my scout up north.
What is this guy?
This is a warrior.
Oh, okay.
With lots of hills. I'm not gonna have much more luck up north because it's a lot of rainforest.
You can't build in the rainforest?
No, I mean as in terms of scouting.
Reconnaissance units like scouts are unique.
Yeah, okay.
Maybe you should read those.
I read it already.
Maybe you should read it for the audience at home. Maybe never played.
You're right. Scouts move fast, but they're weak. Let's build a warrior to
protect
our turn our stuff, and then we would build a builder, and then we would build a monument, and then we would build a settler. So we have our next few things mapped out for us.
Oh man, chocolate.
Yeah, there's some cocoa. There's some dairy, some cattle. Oh, already there's a.
Is that like a
barbarian scout? Can I mess him up?
No, it says you'd suffer a major defeat.
So in the tutorial there wasn't a lot of barbarians, but I'm wondering if in the actual game there's gonna be a lot more. Come at me, swine.
No man ever wetted clay and then all left right. It. As if there would be bricks by chance and fortune.
Alright, so we got pottery, which will help me build a granary, which will increase my
food.
My food, yep. Alright, so I've met a city state. Yeah,
no,
I was the first
quest, right?
Yeah, I was the first civilization to meet Geneva, and so I've earned an envoy. Now I actually don't know what an envoy is.
Well, now you're, I think that your warrior became an envoy.
So we're going to have to look at one. Okay. The bonuses you earn from a city-state depend on how many envoys you have sent to their city-state. After earning envoys, you will receive a prompt to choose which city-state to send them to. If you have multiple envoys, you may divide them into city-states as you desire. Declaring war directly on a city-state removes all envoys you had there. Otherwise, envoys stay at the city-state permanently. Envoys at a city-state are visible to all players, and placing them have diplomatic consequences. The bonuses earned are based on how many envoys you have present, regardless of who else has envoys there. City-states of all types all share the same type bonus. Okay. They are cumulative, so that a player places more and more envoys on a city-state that will stack from bonuses from before. Okay, so that's just how we activate their,
Oh, no, it gave you an envoy. Okay, that's not your warrior.
No, that's a Geneva warrior.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So this is city-state. We automatically got an envoy to them because we were the first to meet them. They're scientific. They don't have a suzerain, which is like their protection or whatever. They're like, they don't belong to another thing. So I got one envoy. So I get automatically. I got +2 science on my capital, which is amazing.
And if you get more envoys. You get science on every campus district. Okay. You need to build campus districts first.
Which is pretty... They come pretty early.
Do they?
Yeah. So, okay. So, what is this? This is their ultimate. If you press R...
You spin around in a circle throwing blades.
Yeah.
It's a rip-off of Katarina.
It's so... Such a rip. Envoys and more than any other civilization... Okay, so I have to have at least...
Three envoys.
And more than any other civilization... I get their unique bonus. Your city's own 15% science bonus when you are not at war with any civilization.
And if you become their suzerain?
I think that is their suzerain.
No, it's a suzerain.
I know, bonus. I think that is.
Them. Oh, okay.
The city-state follows you into war and peace with other players. Your units may enter the city-state lands. Okay. Your builder units may improve city-state tiles. Okay, why would I do that? I mean, I'm sure there's a reason. See three tiles around this. Okay, that's cool. They give you vision. You can pay gold to temporarily take control of the city-state's military. Oh, nice. I can micromanage your crap. And then I gain ownership of all the city-state's resources, but they don't have any right now. So, okay.
So how do you get more envoys?
I don't know right now. I think...
Did it say earlier?
Oh, okay, by the rewards.
Wait, what?
I get rewards.
They want you
if
to
I send
a trade route.
I can do that pretty quick. So I will do that.
Okay.
All right. That's cool. I'm learning. Let's keep on moving.
Thank you.
Is this guy gonna attack my?
You might.
My town. Well, I'm building a warrior.
Okay,
right?
So wait, the scout. Wait, which one's which?
It says major defeat. So,
are you the one on the right?
I am the one on the right. Yeah. I don't know if that's always the case, but yeah. He's an ideal. Oh, and I would be crossing the river. Okay. Let's do. Okay, so let me talk about boosts. You can have a Eureka moment, which boosts the research of things. So if I meet another civilization, writing becomes easier to research. If I found a city on the coast, sailing becomes easier to research. Now, some of these starting texts, it doesn't look like they have, they're not boostable. Animal husbandry, mining. Not boostable.
So maybe you should go for those ones first.
Yeah, that's what I'm going to do. And then I can try to boost them. So as soon as I found a city on the coast, that's permanently boosted. Just like my Elo in League.
It's two League of Legends references for... And as we don't even play that game.
Yeah, I don't even play League. So his vision, he didn't gain any vision on that movement because it's blocked off by a mountain and this rainforest. So I'm loving this rainforest. This is going to be really great for my cities. Now, I probably shouldn't have walked in this direction because I don't think I'm going to be able to get through there without... But I don't know if that's... Like, in the old games, that didn't automatically declare war. They just didn't like me for a second. But I don't see any, like, hate meter, so I wonder if it's... Yeah, I'm just not even going to try. I'm just going to see if I can go around. There's some copper down there. Oh, man, I should definitely work my way up here. There's a lot of resources.
You found a natural wonder. See?
So, that's a boost. That's a eureka moment for...
Is it saying anything? The pantanal... Pantanal? The pantanal is the most complex intertropical...
Alluvial plain, yeah.
And then it's blocked by our recording software. I think we might want to move that back up to the top. Yeah. We can't do that yet, though.
All right. Your knowledge of astrology. Yeah. So my astrology got boosted. So it completed it halfway already, it looks like.
Boosted.
I don't know if that's necessarily exactly how much it got.
Can you get it boosted again?
No. Okay. Because the boosted is discover a world wonder. Now it's been met, so, you know.
So what does this natural wonder give us if we colonize it?
Let me scroll over it and we'll find out.
Enacting new policies in our government can be a great benefit.
Okay, I just...
Our people are waiting to decree.
When you find yourself in a hole, quit digging.
Oh yeah, you have like a tech tree and like a... authority makes a law. Politico tree or whatever?
Yeah, so there's a tech tree and there's like a culture tree now.
Culture tree.
If we work the pantanal, it gives you +2 food and +2 culture.
Cool.
And it's a 4-tile natural wonder. So it looks like there's probably more up there. That's amazing.
Yeah, so you should definitely be like, maybe you should like rush that scout or something, or rush that
settler.
I
could. I don't exactly know how happiness works in this game. There's people need to be entertained.
That's how it was in the first game. You could set people to be entertainers and scientists.
Yeah.
And,
So certain buildings have, like, they need so many entertainment buildings in order to be happy. So we did astrology. See, it's halfway boosted already. So we could do... That gives us the ability to build a holy site district. Or we can do writing, which is not boosted yet, unfortunately. So it would take 8 turns. So let's wait a second on that, and let's do animal husbandry right now, because it's another one of those basic building blocks. Now I can build a greenery, which take 11 turns. A settler,
14 turns.
I really think I need this worker first, this builder. Builders work a little bit different than workers. Also, you can't just hit F to fortify anymore.
What?
Yeah. Okay, so this is a result of our culture. You have these slots that unlock as you build, get more civics trees, upgrades. So first one I'm gonna do is +5 combat unit strength when fighting barbarians.
And I also have an economic policy.
Yeah.
+1 production or faith and gold in the capital.
Right now I'm going to do urban planning. Now, you can change these pretty frequently, I believe. I think as long as you're not at war, you can change them at will, I believe. I could be completely wrong, though. Yeah, let's go this way. Yeah,
so
see?
Beautiful.
Look how big that is. There's another one in there that's... So maybe I'll go up there.
Can you go through it?
Yeah. Not on this turn. He has a movement left, but literally everything else is rough terrain, so... there's an orange down there. I didn't see that one. So, I mean, we're rich in resources right now, guys, but...
I need to build out those city borders and those...
That sucks. Should I try to kill this guy?
Yeah, if you want.
No, I'm not gonna cross. Okay, there we go. If they want to cross, I can, but...
I don't think that leaving a scout is gonna be good for you in any sort of way, you know?
What do you mean?
I don't think leaving him alive is gonna benefit you in any way.
Oh, yeah. So we're gonna have to go. It recommends we go through there, so I don't know if...
Well, yeah, just go through it.
Okay, I'll try.
What's that?
That's a zone of influence, so if you enter someone's zone of influence...
They get an attack of opportunity?
No, you can't... The only thing you can do, the only next movement you can do is attack. If you would lose all your movement.
Okay.
Otherwise. So, like, if I move there, I can't move another hex away or something, but I could attack them, I believe.
If you had another movement left?
Yeah.
Discover a second continent for foreign trade. Is that the only culture thing that you could work on?
No, but it's the one I wanted to do.
Yeah. Okay. It's gonna take a while.
Yeah, they do. They're just like cultures in the old games. Hopefully I kill this guy. Nope.
Wow, you guys just bounced off each other.
That's fine. That's how it works.
Now, actually, what's cool about this game is that you can actually micromanage every little attack that your guys do by pushing buttons, like a fighting game.
Yeah.
And Jonathan just did a quarter circle forward. He Hadoukened, basically.
Just running away. Jade? Nice. Oh, and a friendly village.
More moo cows.
So let's see what it says when I ended my turn in there.
Moving. Why you block?
If there are no dogs in heaven, then when I die, I want to go where they went.
Wow.
Just have them wait, maybe?
There's no point in it. I might as well walk around.
Okay.
Alright, I'm gonna try to trap this guy off.
Yeah, he's not able to move.
If he goes up here, he'll only move one square, so let's see what I get from here. Boosted! State workforce has advanced considerably. Oh, okay, cool. So they boosted my one of my civics. Nice. I wish they had done foreign trade, but I mean, beggars can't be choosers. Now since we boosted astrology, let's do astrology. And if you keep boosting it, I think that's an amazing system because I missed a movement on this guy, but I think it really it rewards players for like wisely choosing their civics and actively trying to boost them and stuff, whereas earlier it was just like, oh, who has more science buildings?
This is our dog now.
Yeah, we got a dog, boy. We dogging it.
Lemon tree.
Our neighbors have made a request of us. If we can impress them, I think they will reward us handsomely.
Tell me more.
Oh, sorry. No, it's just about doing quests.
Are we the first to meet them? It says there should be like. Okay, who's that? Who has the one on board?
Yeah, that's me.
Oh, okay.
So I was the first. And they destroy one barbarian outpost within 5 tiles of the city.
Is there a barbarian outpost right there?
I don't know.
That's a barbarian. Oh, no. That might be them.
Yeah.
This is weirding me out because in Civ 5, God, this is how do you go back? Civilization. Escape.
Oh, there it is.
In Civ 5, they had very specific, like, black and a color checkered border.
Yeah, so you could more easily tell, I feel like. Alright, so I killed that barbarian. I'm gonna send him back to Rio. Oh yeah, and my guy. They're just blocking me off, dude. That's not cool. That's cool because there's a few hexes in there that I haven't discovered. There might be if there's one hex that you haven't seen, you might be missing something. So, not super worried about it. Yep, see, look. There's a friendly village right there. Rice. Lots of rice down there.
Nice. Now, are those... Are those...
Oh, there it is. Oh, he's almost dead, too. I wonder if I can kill him.
With a scout? With a scout.
It's possible. Probably not, though. I might have to send my warrior up there. But he's a spearman.
Ooh, there ain't no way you're doing that.
Especially if he,
Okay, what does it say? Versus him. Major defeat. Yeah, you'd take half damage, and...
I'm gonna try it.
And he would take, like, hardly any.
I'm gonna try it. Alright, so I built my builder. Let's do a monument or a greenery.
Monument.
I'd say monument. And then we will build a settler.
So what is your builder guy gonna do?
First things first, I'm the realist.
Your tongue.
Do I do that a lot? Have I been doing that?
You've been doing it like every other word. It's been like, so first thing we're gonna do.
Okay, so
yeah, it was like the SpongeBob, like, you know, like,
oh yeah, when you went to like the Underdeep or whatever.
Underdeep, yeah, that's what it was called.
Okay, so they boosted irrigation, that's interesting. Okay. I like getting units personally. Again, beggars can't be choosers.
You know what they used to do? They just used to give you technology.
Or they would just attack you. Because sometimes they were just barbarians.
We have recently gained advanced knowledge in city planning.
We're not friendly at all.
Creating districts
planning,
in our cities
can be much more powerful and lucrative
than simple improvements like farms and mines.
A physician without a knowledge of astrology has no right to call himself a physician.
So I can build a holy site, and it gets bonuses from, like, mountains and stuff.
No forest?
No, forest doesn't. What is the jungle bonus for this guy again?
Basically, like, everything.
Just the campus. Oh, and the holy site.
Okay,
interesting. So, my sights are going to be amazing. And then we can... I'm doing it. I hear it now.
And there's,
I can build a quarry.
And that was actually one of the, inspiration bonuses for mining, was build a quarry.
Right. These guys don't build roads, I don't believe. The trade caravans build at roads in between their trade routes.
Oh, okay. Interesting.
Okay. I'm going to choose research. I can do archery, irrigation, farmer resource. Well, I don't have anything to farm right yet.
You sure?
Yeah. Well,
you already got the boosted bonus for it.
Oh, that's right.
So I don't know if...
Oh, yeah. No, okay, that's the farming that I did.
Well, if you... What?
That's the farming that I did. This cattle.
No, you went into the guy, and you went to the friendly village, and they gave you irrigation.
Okay. Writing is still 8 turns, but that's... I guess we can do irrigation. That's only 4 turns. I'm gonna do it, dude. I don't even care.
You're gonna get smackledorfed, dude.
I think I can do it. They said you can't do it, and I said I think I can do it.
Why don't you bring your knight over there, or your warrior?
Once he heals up, I will. If I don't get it. Oh, if they capture it, I'm gonna be so mad.
I think they did.
I'm so mad. I should have waited a turn and then done it.
Killsteel?
Yeah, they killstole. That's Geneva still. So they're just doing their own thing. That's interesting, because I've never seen... In the other games, they wouldn't really leave their... There's a unit available for promotion. So there's a lot of jungle around this area, so I'm going to make it so... He gets the ranger, which is woods and rainforest movement. Also, when you level them up, when you give them a promotion, they heal a little bit. Yeah, so the quest is gone. Unfortunately.
It does suck.
That really sucks.
I helped.
I
should get partial credit.
Right, exactly.
Teacher.
And yeah, we're sending you. Oh, wait, what is this?
This is the builder.
This is the builder, okay. The builder. Build that.
So it does it in one turn? Instantly?
Yes. That's what's great about these builders. They build enhancements in one turn. Why did you go that way? But they only get three builds.
And then they disappear?
Exactly.
So what are you doing? You're farming?
Yeah, I'm probably just going to build that other mine. No,
is that fortify till heal?
Yeah.
Does that require irrigation, I said? The citrus?
Yeah. And I'm not on that hex
right.
yet.
I kept reading it as immigration.
Yeah, no, it takes that too. You need foreigners to pick your fruit, because they take the jobs that no one else wants. I think.
Another continent? What?
Okay.
And you completed it. Where's this other
continent?
That's
the positive aspect of trade, I suppose. The world gets stirred up together.
Oh. Cool. So now
I
have.
All I see is a giant octopus.
Now I have a trade route. I just gained a trade route.
With whom?
I have to build a trader. Yeah, I don't see the continent, but apparently I discovered it. So I wonder if it's close or I don't even know how that works, but.
This is a continent that's separated by a river.
We have discovered a new continent.
Our explorers are naming it Australia.
Okay. I don't know why you would name something Australia.
It means, like, Southland.
Yeah, I know. I was just about to say that, actually. Austria means South. So that we can do craftsmanship, early empire, or mysticism. Early empire, you can ask for open borders, plus 50% towards production of settlers, so settlers build faster. And reduces the cost of purchasing tiles.
I like that. That sounds
good. I do, but it's really expensive right now.
It's 32. Or grow your civilization to at least 6 pop.
Yeah, to gain half of it. So,
can you do that, you think?
I mean, this is already 4.
So maybe work on it, and then by the time you hit 6, it'll complete?
It'll Eureka.
Yeah.
It's possible.
I mean, do the granary, that should give you enough time to, I don't know. It's up to you.
Yeah, we'll figure it out. We're in this together, boys.
I think we're going to try and shoot for hour-long episodes.
Yeah, totally. How we do here?
Probably pretty decisive victory.
Major victory is what it says. It doesn't say that they're going to kill it, though. Let's wait.
For what?
See if they'll attack first, so that way I can ensure myself with the kill.
You're gonna regret it.
You think so? And let's just build another mine.
I like how the stuff that you've already seen, it turns to map.
Yeah. So I did 3 tile improvements, so craftsmanship got boosted.
Boosted! I'm gonna do that every time.
No, please don't.
I'll do it like this.
Boosted. Stop. You just popped the mic, dude. Fortify.
Well, get a pop filter.
Yeah, I have one. I just don't know where it is. I still can't see Australia.
Or I can do it like what's that called? Where like a train goes by?
Thousands have lived without love. Not one without
the
water.
Coriolis effect. The
Doppler effect?
Yeah, the Doppler effect. Boosted.
Please don't.
This would be annoying.
He's not going to attack.
Maybe not. But maybe they'll attack with this guy because he's full health. They don't want to attack with this guy who was hurt. Now one of our lowest is...
archery or...
riding. Riding is only 7.
So is archery.
So I want to get the science up fast.
Wait.
Other states has crystallized ideas. So political philosophy got boosted. I don't know why, because I met...
Is this an...
Olaventa? Is that another city-state?
Yeah, it must be.
Oh, it is. Wow.
Are you the first one with them, too?
Yeah. Plus, I got +2 faith in the capital. Dude, that's crazy. So I should be gaining 2 faith per turn now, maybe? I'm getting lucky.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Seriously lucky.
Yeah, meeting them in the capital is really nice. Getting that first bonus doesn't look like they're gonna. If they do, you know they're gonna. Like, I'm gonna do all the work and then they're gonna run in for the last attack. That's really gonna burn my grits. God dang it. This is such bullcrap. I should just destroy. What is it?
That's what you get,
suckers.
Wait.
Yeah.
I should just burn Geneva to the ground.
Yeah, I should just burn Geneva. But so it looks like they already have horsemen. Which means that just means it's a barbarian encampment with horses nearby. They don't do tech. They just do whatever. Next close to them. By. Yeah, so I'm gonna fortify right there until I'm healed.
Can you do that outside of your city walls? Sorry, I didn't realize that was your foot.
Just caressed my foot.
Yeah. Next, I'm gonna try and grab his hand and just hold it for a little bit.
So, I could do a holy site.
You really kind of want that settler. I do. That's only 7 too.
I do. I really want that settler. We'll do the settler, and then we'll.
Work on that whole site.
Yeah.
You gotta breeze. You gotta do breeze. The whole S.
And by that time, I might want to do the holy site. I might want to do the, science district.
Oh, science district, okay.
Here's another friendly town. He's already healed up, so we could send him. Let's keep him here in anticipation for our settler. We don't want to send our settler out alone.
Escort, yeah.
Oh, the horse kicked and ran away. Okay, so I can move this guy up here now. We can try to find the encampment. Oh, we got a builder unit. Nice.
Where is he at?
Is he
right here? That's a scout.
I wonder if they awarded it somewhere else.
In your like home city, maybe.
Yeah, that would be nice.
Marvel. What's that? Oh, okay.
Dude, that is amazing. Let's actually keep him here for now. Actually, how much money do I have? I have 153.
Your coffers are bursting at the seams, Jam.
Purchase tile. 2 turns until border growth. I can purchase this for 95. Naturally, it's going to go here.
Now, if you... Wait, can you wait 2 turns? Well, if you purchase, will that go away?
I don't know. I don't think so.
I don't think so either.
Let's purchase.
You want the citrus? Citrus? Okay, now look. Nope, okay, it's still gonna grow.
And then we'll have him build over here. And then the other two turns I'll use for my next city. Now, I do want to build that trader pretty quick because I can send it to Geneva.
What would the trader's name be?
Joe.
Yeah.
Typically. But we'll see. Am I building the settler right now? Yeah.
Yeah. Guys.
You are really, like, boxing me out here, guys. I'm gonna be honest.
You're really tickling my fritz.
I don't know what that means. Some ivory?
It's like burning my grits, but a little less so.
That's
a dragon.
It's a dragon. He's got a gun. I might have gotten extremely lucky and just be on an island with a few, city-states.
Yeah, but then you're like, you have like no interaction with other people.
Right. It's possible, but at the same time, I could still just be doing these quests and...
Do you think those Geneva warriors are just like, nope,
yeah.
You're not gonna get here.
Not in my house. Oh, there's no dragon here.
They freaking lied to you.
Yeah. There be not dragons here. Yeah, dude. The plantation up there. Yeah, all it takes is one giant hammer strike.
Okay, so what'd that give you?
That's a luxury resource.
Like trading.
Yeah, it also gives me plus 4 food and plus 1 gold.
Does it give you happiness?
I don't.
Because luxury resources, isn't that what a luxury resource would do?
Let me look.
For food, shows you the production.
Yeah, so I can trade out
maybe
one of these.
Maybe it's the gold that it's really for. Oh wait, what are you doing?
I just locked it.
Why? What does that mean?
I don't know. I was trying to click it off, but.
What is that doing?
I don't. It's like. Okay, it doesn't really matter. Between this and that, it doesn't really matter. I just wanted this on there. I don't know why I couldn't just take it one off and then put it on there.
Put one what?
A working citizen on there.
Oh, so does that mean you're working the tiles?
Yeah. So that's my citizens are working the tiles. Stop locking it. Okay, there.
So, and then that means, like...
Yeah, I kind of messed my stuff up, because this was on here locked. It's 3 food, and this wasn't even being worked, which is 3 food and a production.
Okay.
So it's literally just worse than...
Okay.
Let's see, so here's 3 food, 1 production.
So maybe you could put a district there.
Yeah. I don't know if putting a district makes it unworkable, or destroys my improvements or anything. We'll have to see, because I would like to put it, right here...
Why is that?
Because it's adjacent to a mountain, which is good, and also adjacent to rainforest. Or I might put it, up...
That's a lot of production.
Yeah, I might put it, up here, which is, super adjacent to rainforest. We'll see. I'm almost done with, writing. But I do want the trader... The next thing I'm gonna do is a trader, no matter what, I think. And then a science district.
You want to walk him up and
yeah.
Get
he's
him ready with the...
Yeah, he's going to go to my next city. Another barbarian encampment. And this is a scout, so it's not going to...
It's not going to fare well. Wait, what did it say?
Major defeat.
Major defeat, okay.
Hopefully they don't attack me, but they probably will.
They're spearsmen.
Yeah, that's just the basic
thing. Writing means sharing. It's part of the human condition to want to share things. Thoughts, ideas, opinions.
Yeah, so there's my writing, so now I can build this campus district.
Nice.
Yeah, let's move away. Back up, because it's on. They want me to do bronze working, which reveals iron and also allows me to build spearmen and encampment and barracks. That takes 11, however, so I'm going to do archery or masonry.
Grants a builder, all builders can build one extra improvement, must be built on a desert tile.
Yeah, I don't think I have any desert near me, unfortunately.
That's kind of interesting.
Yeah, but I could do
that. They never used to restrict wonders like that.
Yeah, now they do, and it's kind of good. It makes sense. Like Petra, you could build it, and it might not have helped you. Yeah, I don't really have any desert around me, so I don't think I'll be building the pyramids.
Yeah, beach?
Yeah, that's not the same thing. Just because it's sand doesn't mean...
What? Oh, you're going to tell me that there's a difference between beach sand and desert sand?
Yeah.
Name one thing that's different.
Their coarseness.
You don't know that.
Where did this guy come from? I bet you...
What guy?
This guy right here. See, that's the thing is, if there's...
They can just jump up, too.
Oh, he's right here. Alright, let's take this guy and come over here again.
What?
What is this? What is this? This is my settler. Oh, so this is where I shouldn't build?
Where's that, or where you can't build, maybe?
I don't know.
Yeah, I don't think you can build in those tiles. Yeah, look, you're too close or something like that.
Yeah, these are three away from something else. I probably can build there, but I probably shouldn't. Let's link this settler up here, and then let's go over here. I mean, I could do it right here.
You kind of want to be on that wonder, though, don't you? The natural wonder.
Where's that?
Right there. Right here.
I could. Which, I could build it up here, maybe.
I don't know, man.
Banana. Cocoa. Chocolate. I kind of want to be on this river, too, I believe.
So, like, right here?
Maybe.
They said that was a good tile.
Like right here, right here. I don't know why it's recommending here instead of here.
What's the white tiles then?
White tiles are probably neither good nor bad. Like the red's probably you can't. Yeah.
Okay. Oh.
Because I have to cross a river and go under a hill, it costs you can't move at all.
What are you doing?
It costs two turns to make that movement. This guy he's trying to pillage my crap.
Get your warrior out.
Okay, you know what? Warrior, you come down here.
Oh, he's moving with the guy.
Didn't mean to do that. Can I unlink him? And then he'll meet up with this warrior over here. And builder, you can go right here. Now, I wonder if I have to have a builder to repair this, if they pillage it.
Maybe, I don't know.
It didn't look like he pillaged it. Which I guess I'm lucky. But I should, I still want to fight him.
Yeah, and move down there to the encampment.
Okay, settler, you're going to go up here. Builder as well.
Builder as well.
And just more exploring right here. That looks like it might be the top of the map.
I mean, you've got a pretty good spread here.
Yeah.
And then it just needs to expand outwards.
Oh, I thought I saw someone up here.
Yeah, like a
forest. Oh, it's just trees. All right. Can't decide.
I think we go here.
You think so?
Yeah.
He thinks right here. That's next to copper, or close to copper, deer.
Is it saying wheat. There because it's marshland and it's not very good, or?
I mean, that gives you three food. I mean, that's decent.
Oh, it named the panacea.
Yeah.
Appeal average, and then what's the other appeal?
This is minus two.
Uninviting. What does that mean?
I don't know. People don't want to come here. Like tourism. It might affect tourism later.
It's really marshy, just like Ohio.
Yeah. Ohio sucks.
Well, we drained the swamp. The black swamp.
We did. We literally did drain the swamp.
We got to that 200 years before Trump did.
Getting political, boys. You know, I really can't go against the game's wishes here.
Okay.
But I think I'm gonna move one more to the right. Right here.
Yeah.
That's still next to fresh water, I believe. And, yeah,
it's breathtaking. Oh wait, that's the mountain.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm definitely gonna have to move right here. See, it is next to the river. You can see. So that's still a good spot. And it's a little bit farther away from my other city, which is good.
Okay. You're gonna have to build up to that wonder then, I think, probably.
That's fine. That's fine. I'm not in a rush. Let's get bananas. I'm just chasing this guy down. Ooh.
Whoa.
Timerus Scythia. Let it be known between us, I will repay treachery with blood. But if you are a true friend, we will have peace. We have a city nearby. Would you like to visit? We could fit you for one of our pointy hats.
Pointy hats.
I would love to. When I met the Egyptians, they said that they would like to have me in for some board games.
Yeah?
I said, yeah, you guys got Settlers of Catan? So this is Russia? I don't know. Scythia?
Pokrovia. No, it's Scythia, man.
I've never heard of this. Scythian Empire. Can we Civilopedia this? Scythia?
The Scythians were a loose, very loose confederation of illiterate nomad pastoralists who wandered about the steppes of Central Asia for about 1,000 years. Most of what is known of them comes from a handful of ancient historians, the likes of the Greek Herodotus and the Roman Greek Strabo, and a few Hindu texts. Notice the historians.
Scare quotes, yeah. That's interesting.
Dan Carlin of Hardcore History loves to talk about how Herodotus was more of a storyteller. He was a playwright more than a historian.
Yeah.
And his historical works have such an incredible flair for the dramatic, and I don't think that he let facts get in the way of that sometimes.
So I encourage you all to read that. I scrolled through all of it. I'm going to read it on my own time. But yeah, we'll come back in the next episode with a little bit more knowledge of the Scythian people. So this area is probably all tapped out in terms of friendly villages, but you never know. Looks like they are doing some fighting with a barbarian encampment.
Some burbs.
Okay, I think we're gonna put this guy, this settler down, like do a little bit of improvement, and
we're gonna move to Geneva.
Hell yeah!
That's gonna give us another envoy. So Rio receives +3 gold and +2 science.
Does he have to make it there first?
No, you get that every turn as soon as you start it.
Really?
But.
In addition to bringing riches to our civilization, this trade route will gradually develop roads between our cities. Roads allow our units to no longer be impaired by the difficult terrain through which they pass.
So you can see building trade routes also builds roads. Nice, and currency just got boosted. Okay, so settler, move here. Yeah, this is where you're gonna build. So yeah, we just got a new envoy from Geneva. They don't have any quests yet. One more envoy, and we get +2 science in every campus district, which is coming up soon. We're gonna build some campus districts soon, as in right now, I believe.
Oh, you did just build that.
Yeah. So campus is gonna take 10 turns.
So you can build both Stonehenge and Hanging Guards.
Yeah, but those take a while. So Stonehenge gives you +2 faith and grants a free great prophet.
They may found a religion on Stonehenge instead of a holy site.
Okay, so you don't need a holy site to start a religion.
So it's like you can think of it as like a 8+ turn holy site instead, you know?
Yeah. But I would probably still want the holy site.
Maybe.
And then Hanging Gardens increases growth by 15 in all cities, but it must be next to a river.
That's pretty good.
That's pretty good.
Yeah.
Let's build this campus first and then see where we're at. We really want this campus. So yeah, this will destroy the marsh, which is fine, honestly. But it does not destroy the thing. So it's saying here I could buy this, and that would give me +2 science.
Because it's adjacent to a rainforest?
Yeah. It's just 2 rainforests. So I can't build in the rainforest. I wonder if I cleared one of the rainforests and then put it here. If that would,
Well, can you, are you thinking about building more campuses?
I think you can only have one per city.
Oh, okay.
So if we wait a second and
bring this guy back,
can he clear a forest?
What is this done? Oh, that's a mine.
Okay. Yeah. Do we need iron working to clear rainforests?
Why would we?
I think that's something that you need. Yeah, it doesn't say. If we type in iron working. What does iron working give us? Unlock swordsman, that and that. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know how to clear rainforests. So we'll just do it.
Well, think about it. That gives you 2 science. Is it because you're next to 2 tiles of rainforest?
Yeah, so that's what I was saying. If I clear this rainforest, or like this rainforest, right? And it's surrounded by 8 or 6 rainforests.
Yeah.
Wouldn't that be amazing?
Yeah, but I just don't know if it's worth it. Because you might want to try and keep those up for, like, later. Like, you could build, like, your holy city or your holy site right there instead, you know?
Yeah.
And get a lot more.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, you're right.
Ain't no point in, you know.
And then we will buy this.
We got the money for it.
So that'll take that 10 turns.
Oh, okay.
That'll take 10 turns to build.
So it's not like a improvement.
Right, exactly. Oh man, this guy's almost dead. I could take him out.
That's not a barbarian, I don't think.
Yes, it is.
Yes. Oh, yeah, you're right.
Yes, it is.
They have red banner backgrounds.
Yeah.
Oh, I think I said they will have a quest for you.
I think that was... I was just completing a quest. Get wrecked.
Your Grace, we have obtained greater knowledge in the art of building static fortifications. Building walls around our cities.
Yeah, each of us is carving a stone.
Yeah, also do bombardment with, city walls. Okay. I was wondering if they had a bombardment.
Yeah, but you need a wall of some sort. Or an encampment.
Dude, that's a huge ass... That's the end of the sentence. That convoy is being pulled by a huge ass.
Let's do bronze working, because I think I'll have killed three barbarians by this time, so I'll get the boost.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Does it have to be barbarian warriors, or...?
No, it just says barbarians.
Oh, come on.
Yeah, it wasn't likely that I was going to kill him. There is, however, this guy up here who might...
That's a scout.
Doesn't matter. So I think I have one more that I have to do, but I believe.
I think we're just going to be building a...
city. Oh, early empire. Nice.
Look back over the past.
How far away were you?
Changing empires that rose and fell.
So now I have these as well. 50% towards settlers, reduces the cost of purchasing tiles. So that those were the two that one gave me. Right now I'm gonna stick with what I have. Oops, I did not mean to do that.
And you made Fortaleza. I don't know how to say that. Fortaleza?
Yeah, I'm not sure, actually. So right now, the only thing that's in this hex, because I decided to build it one over, is this,
banana plantation?
Banana. So we'll do that. And that gives you one gold, two food, and two production. Now, I will also build this one over here. And then see if I can trade it away. Let's talk to Tamiris. She is backstab averse.
What does that mean?
It means she likes civilizations who are their declared friend, and hates civilizations who backstab and declare surprise wars. So she's more receptive to warmonger penalties.
Okay.
And she's less likely to backstab people. She's very loyal. Very loyal. The most loyal. No one's more loyal than her. She got the best friends. Let us make a deal.
What
Tom
is,
Brady.
What is...
She's only got one luxury resource, which is Mercury.
Tom Brady's a football player.
Yeah.
Wayne Brady.
Wayne Brady. That's who I said. I said,
You said Tom Wayne Brady.
Yeah. I said Joe Montana.
What does sending a delegation do?
So, a delegation. If I send a delegation, it costs me 20 fold. It sends them a gift, and then they're a little bit more friendly. So, she's just like, hey, here's 25 gold. Let's be friends. So, she's still neutral, but we do gain a little bit more access. Which, the more access we get, the more and more we know about her.
Okay.
Oh, and we get to choose a pantheon here. So let's do that. And after we end this turn, we'll end the episode here. So this is simply all this faith is literally just from my envoys, I believe. Holy Site districts gets plus one faith from adjacent tundra tiles. We'll not do that. Holy Site gets.
We're looking for a rainforest one. Is there a scroll down?
Yeah, sacred path right here from adjacent rainforest tiles. So that could be really good. I can go hardcore on the faith with that probably.
Yeah.
But I do have to clear one of those rainforests in order to be able to do that. And after this episode, I'm going to look up what I need to be able to clear rainforests.
Luxury and bonus resources.
So amenity, that's what people need to be happy.
Okay.
Plus one great person point. It's a classical era wonders.
Plus one food from wine, incense, cocoa, tobacco, coffee, and tea plantations.
Coffee, chicken, Cheetos. Yeah, honestly, plus two faith
from cultures from banana, citrus, dyes, silk, spices. That's pretty good. That's if you want to go a culture route, yeah.
Yeah.
Because you have a lot of those already. And you're going to be just getting more. City growth rate is 10%
higher? Dude, that's crazy. And border expansion rate is 15% higher? Oh my god.
God of War, I love that game.
Kratos, the God of War! That's a Jarma joke. We freaking love Jarma. Just watch Jarma. Just turn off this video right now and watch Jarma. I think we're gonna do Sacred Path, which is
the rainforest.
Forest, yeah. Rainforest.
My dad says that calling things rainforest is politically correct, and that it's just that they're all jungles.
Wait, what? They're just wet. They're just wet trees. All right.
But it's the liberal indoctrination that makes them be rainforests.
Yeah, they're crying liberal tears. Alright, earn a great profit and start a full religion, which adds two beliefs. Okay, so I'm close. Let's choose a production here.
The civic?
Yeah, I'll choose a civic as well. First things first.
I'll eat your brains. And then I'm gonna start rocking gold teeth and fangs. Cause that's what a motherfucking civilization do.
I need that. Let's build a granary.
Okay. You got that warrior protecting you, so it's not big of a deal.
Yeah.
Is there a warrior in this area?
There's a warrior right here.
Okay.
I wanna get this, three barbarians really quick before I end my turn. Before I end this video. Craftsmanship, classical melee range units, and towards builders.
What does the mysticism give you?
Plus two great profit points per turn, plus two great scientist points per turn. I would have to put it in as part of my government. And then access to the oracle. And that's boosted, so it only costs 6.
Yeah.
So I think I'm definitely gonna do that. I really hope my guys don't die.
Shouldn't.
I really hope my guys don't die. Just found a foreign dead. Appears they come from Brazil.
Wait, what? Where Brazil?
Yeah.
Oh. Okay.
See, there you go. Just got boosted. Oh, bronze working got boosted.
So it's up to 3 turns now.
Yeah.
Okay. Cool.
So I am going to back up to try to keep my guy alive here.
And I think that we could just call it right here.
Yes, absolutely. Thank you for joining us, guys. We will see you tomorrow. We plan on doing at least an hour a day. Right now we're at 69 minutes, so really...
Really, and it's the perfect time to stop. If we could end it at 69... minutes
69
and 420 seconds
we would, but yeah, you know,
unfortunately time doesn't work that way.
Yeah, I mean, you have to be real creative to get something like that to work. All right, guys, I love you, and I'll see you tomorrow.